One of the things that sets MediaShout apart from basic presentation software is the ability to add items to your presentation that perform a function rather than just playing a piece of media. Since this is a relatively unique concept to many new users, one of the most requested ShoutTip topics has been using script control cues to create announcement loops. This feature in MediaShout for Mac is similar and known as a script command. As I just mentioned, MediaShout includes certain types of cues that don't play media themselves, but rather perform a function or affect another cue in your presentation. So let's look at how script commands work by building an announcement loop. First, let's add some announcements to our presentation. I'll use the Files tab of the Media Deck to find my folder of announcement graphics. I have it set up as a shortcut in my sidebar. I'll select the graphics I want to add and drag them into my script. Now I'll select them all and click one of the Edit buttons to edit them all at the same time. Once Cue Editor opens, click on the Cue tab, and we'll use the Inspector window to change the Advanced type to Timed, and let's use the 5-second default. Click OK, and we're set. Now I also want to add a video promoting an upcoming mission trip to South Africa, so I'll browse for that video in my deck and drop it at the bottom of my script. Open Cue Editor for the video, and using the Inspector window of the Cue layer again, we'll change the Advanced type to End of Picture, which automatically advances the cue at the end of the video file, and click OK. Next, I'll use the More Elements deck to add a script command to the bottom of my announcement graphics, but above the video. Once I drop it into the script, the Cue Editor automatically opens, and now I can choose how I want the script command to work. Using the Inspector window, set the target to the first cue in my presentation, since we want the last announcement to loop back to the first announcement. I can either set the repeat setting to none, loop, or a specific number of times. I'll set it to 2, since I want the series of announcement graphics to repeat 2 times before playing my video. Click OK, and we're almost ready to play our announcement loop. Finally, I'll add another script control right below the video that uses the first cue again as my target and the repeat set to loop. Now my group of announcement slides will play 3 times before the video plays and then loop back to the beginning of my script, playing the slides 3 times again, and so on. So as you can see, script commands can be used for creating simple loops or in combination with one another to create more intricate automation. Do you have other topics you'd like to see us cover? We'd love to hear from you. Head over to our new support page at mediashout.com/support, where you can find links to our forums, as well as Facebook, Twitter, and YouTube. Leave us a comment in any of these communities, or send an email to shouttips@mediashout.com.